a signal xt is given like this, minus 2 to 4. It is defined for t is equal to minus 2 to 4 and its amplitude is 6. The question is given to find the even and odd parts of the signal xt. So to find the even and odd parts, we have the equation for even part x et is equal to xt plus x of minus t divided by 2. So xt we have given in the equation already. So x of minus t is the folded version of the signal xt. So it can be plotted like this here as shown in this plot. So it is just a reversal, time reversal operation. So the positive time index goes to the negative time index. So 4 becomes minus 4 in the left side, and this minus 2 becomes plus 2 in the right side. So the signal is just a mirror image of the given signal xt, and its amplitude is not changed. It is same to the given signal xt, 6, here also 6. Thus time indexes are reversal or like mirror image of the given signal. So this is x of minus t. Now for x even t, we have to add these two signals xt plus x of minus t. So these two signals are defined from minus 2 to 4 here, from minus 4 to 2 here. So in the negative time domain, time direction, it is maximum limit is minus 4, and in the positive time direction, it has maximum limit is plus 4. So it is defined from minus 4 to plus 4. So we have find out the indexes here, minus 4 to plus 4, and other indexes in the signal xt was minus 2. So we have to find out minus 2 here, and other index in the x of minus t was plus 2. So we have found out the time index 2 here. So now if we add this to signal, we can see that x of minus t is defined from minus 4 to 2. So minus 4 to minus 2, we first assume the part minus 4 to minus 2. So this signal starts as minus 2. So before that, we have only x of minus t, which amplitude is 6. So we plotted the signal here, minus 4 to minus 2 with amplitude 6. Okay, now at minus 2, we have two parts of the signals. If we are adding xt and x of minus t, so we will get from xt at minus 2, we are getting 6. And here also at minus 2, suppose here, so we are getting at 6 below here. So 6 plus 6, we are getting 12. So at minus 2, we have value are reaching at 12, and it goes up to this part, because after 2, the signal is not defined. So after 2, we are getting plus 12, and after 2, its value is 0, but its xt value is 6. So we are getting a value of 6 plus 0 as 6 here, from 2 to 4. And after 4, the signal is defined up to 4 only here. So maximum limit is 4. So it's become 0 at 4, and after that it is all 0. So this is the signal xt plus x of minus t. So for finding even part, we have to divide the value that we are getting by 2. So we have just only divide the magnitude here. So it was 12 here, it is 6 here. So we can write 6 and 3, 6 and 3 as shown here for the even part of the signal, and the other time indexes are not changed. So this dividing by 2 is just dividing the magnitude of the signal. So magnitude is scaled to 6 and 3 here, and time indexes are same. So this is the even part of the signal. So similarly, to find out the odd part of the signal, so we know that the odd signal is given as xt minus of x minus t divided by 2. So xt and x of minus t we have already found here, xt and x of minus t. So the limit will be same, minus 4 to plus 4, and the values are to the subtract. This xt is defined from here, minus 2, and x of minus t is defined from minus 4. So if we subtract xt minus x of minus t, so we will get from minus 4 to minus 2, we will get negative value minus 6. And then we have to add subtract xt and x of minus t. So we will be subtracting 6 minus 6 as 0, and up to point plus 2 we are getting 0, and then after 2 we will be getting this value plus 6 of xt up to 0.4. So that is why this plot comes here like this. So minus 4 to minus 2, we are getting minus 6 from x of minus t. And here plus 6, because xt was 6 from 2 to 4 and x of minus t was 0. So plus 6 we are getting here. So this magnitude is 6 and this magnitude is minus 6. So if we divide by 2 this signal, then we get here plus 3 and minus 3, and this signal xt minus x minus t by 2 is nothing but your odd part of the given signal.